Hey guys, welcome to Fur Tutorials. Guys, today I create really cool and satisfying animation in Cinema 4D. So firstly guys, you can take any object like cube, cone and sphere. But guys, I take cone and change cone size. Bottom radius I take randomly like 20 and height I take 40 cm. Right? Guys, now second object I take cylinder and change cylinder radius. Radius I take only 0.8 cm and height decrease like 150, right? Okay, good. Guys, go to front view panel. So select this cylinder and up like this and more little bit. Yeah, that's it, right? Okay. Now, guys, select this cylinder and actually select both objects and right click connect object plus delete, right? And rename like anything like object, right? And guys, change this object center pivot. So I go to again front view panel. Click here, enable axis, go on top and create zoom in like this, go on up, closer, yes, yeah. See guys, this is now center and enable axis uncheck. See guys, select this object and this is my center pivot, right? Guys, this is my first object. And now I create second object. So guys, I create wheel. So I take cylinder and change rotation. This one and change this size. So cylinder and like radius increase. Radius I take like 100 cm. 100 and height decrease like 15. Guys, go on display select all shading lines. Guys, I increase the segments, rotation segments I take 100. Yes, right? That's really good. Okay, now guys, I create shape. So I go to right view panel, select this object and go on up little bit. Yes. Okay, now guys, this time I take cube and make editable this cube. Click here and change size. So I take scale tool, make smaller. Yes. And guys, go on here, point and rectangle selection check. And closer, create shape like this. Here. Yes, right guys, this is my shape. And now, so guys, select polygon, select only top face and right click extrude and extrude go on up. That's it guys. Yeah, great. Okay, now guys, I take cloner. So I go to more graph and use cloner. So select this one shape and make child with cloner. Guys, select cloner and more. I take grid array, actually this one, radial and plane, take mid one. Yes, and guys, count I take only 4 and you can increase more radius like this. Actually, I go to right view panel and set this radius. Yeah, right. See guys, that's good. Okay, guys, you can take, I create curve effect on here. So uncheck cloner and select this cube. Guys, I take edges, select this one and this one. Select both edges and right click, take bevel and offset decrease and increase subdivision. Like subdivision, I take 10. Yeah. See, great. Okay, now I create hole. So guys, I take bowl and select the shape cylinder, go on top, select cloner and this one cylinder and make child with bowl. Great. See guys, right? Okay, so select bowl and hide new edges, check. Yeah, see guys, this is my wheel, right? Okay, now guys, also create smoothness on here edges. So select cylinder and go to caps and fill it, check. And radius, I take like 2 cm. Yes. And increase segments, I take like 10. Right? So guys, this is my simple shape is create. And now guys, I take cube, actually you can take plane and increase size, plane height increase, like increase randomly and change this web size here. Yes, great. Okay guys, select this plane and make editable, click here and I select this polygon. Guys, select this shape like this and press delete key, right? This my holo object. And now guys, I take edges, so select this plane and select all edges, right? It's so easy guys. Also here, yeah. Okay, now select all edges and right click extrude. And guys, subdivision in actually angle increase and apply, actually not like this, -90. Yeah, yes, that's it guys, right? It's great. Okay, now one more cube guys, I take one more cube on here. Great. Okay guys, all is good. Now I create animation, is most important part of this animation. Okay, so guys, I select this object and increase frame like only 100 frames. Guys, I create seamless animation and select this object and go to chord. Guys, select only chord and see, this is my rotation, right? And rotation R dot B, right? Okay, so guys, go to zero frame and R B rotation, I take like -70, actually not 70, only 70. Yes, and press this animation key, right? Okay, now I go to 50 frames, 50, and this time R B rotation take -70 and check. Guys, go to lastly 100 frame and R B rotation take same 70 and check, right? See guys, that's good, simple, right guys? Okay, and second animation guys, I create here wheel animation. So actually select this wheel and guys, you can take save. So guys, right click on this bowl, select children, and one more time right click, connect object plus delete, and guys, rename like wheel. Yes guys, this is my wheel, and select wheel and go to chord, and guys, this is my rotation, right? And rotation R dot P. So guys, zero and check on here on zero frame, P rotation take zero, And guys, I go to like 25 frame. Here I go to 25 frame and rotation like 90 and check, right? Okay, so guys, I go to 50 frame and rotation, I take 180 degree and check. And I go to like 75 frame and rotation to 70 and check. And lastly, go to 100 frames and R.P take 360 and check, right? So guys, play. But guys, this is not correct. See, it's not seamless animation, right? So little bit change on wheel keyframes. So select this wheel and I go to window. Here, this is my timeline F curve. See guys, this is my all keyframes, right? So select all keyframes, right? And go to interpolation. Guys, use only liner. Yeah, see guys, this should be on straight keyframes. So close, and now this is my seamless animation. See guys, that's really good. See, I show you on closer. So, and increase frame like this. See guys, right? It's not untouchable. And increase here, right? See guys, yeah, that's really good. It's on position. And go to back and play. Right. Guys, I love this animation. It's so easy without any using Expresso and without any coding. So now all is good. So guys, I apply text on here. Go to more text. Object any type C4D and alignment take middle. Guys, font I use anyone, it's not necessary. Open font like Roboto and rotation 90 degree and rotate -90. Apply on here. Yeah, that's it guys, right? Okay, now guys, I apply textures. So I go to create and load material. This my materials and open. Apply red material on here. Guys, use white material. So this is my white material, open. And diffuse, uncheck, color, I take white. That's it. So apply on here. And also more text. This is one. And apply on here also object, right? Guys, I apply black material on here, open. See, this is my black material and second one also. So bump uncheck and all is good. So close and apply, right? It's good like this. Closer. And guys, set camera angle and camera check. Guys, lock this camera. So go to Cinema 4D tag and use protection. I lock this camera on here. Yeah, great. And use light also. Go to file and merge. Select C4D studio light and open. Run check camera. Guys, select flow and background and down. Set light. Yeah, that's it guys. So close and all is good. So go to render setting. Guys, this time use only global illumination, not use ambient occlusion. So empty, select best. And this is my save file path. Use mp4 and desktop this one, take any folder name and file, output, use all, this one, okay. I take full HD frame and all frame. So close and render, press OK. So guys, this my animation is finished. So if you like my video, please share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.